Here is Sri D.P. Tripathi.
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chairman. With due regard to the President of the Republic, I must say that this is the first presidential address which has neither the dress nor the dressing. Why I say this? Because both the form and content are faulty. As the old Sanskrit saying, Gadyam kavinam nikashavadanti, prose is the litmus test of poets. The prose of this address is very stale and awful. To use Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee's metaphor, there is no smile in the speech. Form becomes very important in expressing the imagination and dreams of people. Before I come to the analysis of the address, Mr. Vice Chairman, I must seek your permission to make a few points and not repeat, because I would make new points, I would not repeat what the other honorable speakers have said before me. So before I begin the discussion on the presidential address, I must point out the most shocking omission in this address. That is, there is no mention about the hope and future of India. The children of India and their rights find no mention in the address at all. Whereas, if you look at the two presidential addresses that I want to discuss in comparison to the present one, was the first by Dr. Rajendra Prasad after the first elected parliament in 1952, and the second is the first presidential address during the prime ministership of Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee in 1998. They all talk about the children. This is the first time that children are not mentioned. Where you talk about Beti Bachao and Beti Padhao, you don't read your own economic survey, which says it's social survey, that there are not one or two, 21 million unwanted girl children in India.
Yes.
Not one. And I'm not saying this. Economic survey is saying this. It is very good that through his maiden speech, the president of the ruling Bharatiya Janata Party, Sri Amit Bhai Shah, initiated the debate. He has made a few points. So before I come to the address, which he elucidated, explained, and enlarged about the achievements of the Modi government in all sectors of our national life, before I analyze a couple of points raised by him, I must ask a question to him. If you have made so much progress under the NDA government led by Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi, why it is that India is behind even Pakistan, Bhutan, and Nepal in the happiness index issued by the United Nations a few months ago?
Yes.
Why it is so? Kindly read the entire happiness index report and you'll find it shameful where India is positioned, where India is. The second point, you talked about many achievements and contributions. What I see about your government is described very well in the ancient text of Shatapatha Brahman, which says, Vagahi Vajraha, Vagahi Shastram, Vagu Sarabam Bheshajam. Speech is the Vajra, speech is the weapon, speech is the medicine for all diseases. So speeches after speeches without any actions. This is the government led by Shri Narendra Modi. And this address is without, it looks like Prime Minister's election speech without his oratorical skills. Now, Shri Amit Shah talked about the great coalition dharma that he is following. How, despite majority, after 30 years, they took all other partners along and formed the NDA government. What is there? How they are running the coalition? You just heard Shri Venkatesh of the Telugu Desam. He was talking about the stepmotherly treatment meted out to the Andhra government. His leader, Shri Chandrababu Naidu, is reported to have said to his MPs yesterday, which is idly reported in the media today, not only pressure, disrupt the parliament, demand for the rights of people of Andhra Pradesh. This is what he has said. The recent statement of Shiv Sena chief Shri Uddhav Thackeray, as before all of you, he has said, from leader of the opposition to Shri Shukhinder Shekhar Roy, all of them have talked about this doubling of the income of the farmers. I'll come to that later. But Shri Uddhav Thackeray says that it is baseless. This promise is baseless. These are his words, not my words. Then the demand of the Telugu Desam has been supported by our friend Shri Naresh Gujral of the Akali Dal. So the voices of your coalition partners are very great. This coalition seems to be uniquely cohesive, where there are all kinds of voices. Prime Minister Narendra Modi last time quoted my friend Nida Fazli, to the best of my memory, while replying to the vote of thanks to the presidential address last year. I think I should also quote Nida Fazli about the kind of coalition that you are running. Nida Fazli ka sher hai, dushmani kitni me ho, par rishta nibhate rahiye, dushmani kitni ho, par rishta nibhate rahiye, dil mile ya na mile, haath milate rahiye. This is how you are running the coalition. दुश्मनी कितनी भी हो रिश्ता निभाते रहिए दिल मिले या न मिले हाथ मिलाते रहिए तो ये निदा फाजली ने
हिंदी में आ गए अब आगे
हिंदी आ रहा हमारा थोड़ा सा नाउ द सेकंड पॉइंट अबाउट आई थिंक आई शुड टॉक अबाउट द टू प्रेसिडेंशियल एड्रेसेस एंड कंपेयर दिस वन विथ द two addresses. One, of course, is the address, as I mentioned, in 1952 after the election of the first Parliament of Independent India, the address delivered by Dr. Rajendra Prasad. In many ways, it is unfair on my part to compare this one with the present one. Even then, I must request you to read this address, because it gives a vision of New India. You are talking about New India in the concluding para of the presidential address. Now, this New India, how this can be made, for that you should read this presidential address of 1952, where Dr. Rajendra Prasad talks about the high destiny of India, its civilizational values, the vision of a new country, and wisdom and tolerance of spirit. He talks in detail about this. And you will be surprised to know that in the very first address after the election of Indian Parliament in 1952, there are six large paragraphs about the foreign policy of India and international relations. How you should build the presence of your nation in the world, that is described in this lecture. And of course, all sections of society are mentioned. I'm saying this because this address has more emphasis, if you read it carefully, on the government and much less on the people. Whereas the address by Dr. Rajendra Prasad talks about the onward march of the people, the basic essence of the people. लोकतंत्र की परिभाषा अगर संक्षेप में देना हो तो मैं कहता हूं कि लोकतंत्र साधारण की असाधारणता है. एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरीनेस ऑफ द ऑर्डिनरी इज डेमोक्रेसी. जो शक्ति जनता में होती है, सामान्य जन में होती है, उसी से लोकतंत्र चलता है. एंड इन दिस एड्रेस पीपल आर मोर और लेस एब्सेंट. यू डू नॉट टॉक अबाउट द पीपल्स एंडेवर एंड एफर्ट्स. Whereas the address by Dr. Rajendra Prasad talks about all that. Now I come to another one from which you have not taken any lessons. That is the first address, presidential address, when Atal Bihari Vajpayee assumes office as Prime Minister of India. It gives a vision. One can agree or disagree. That is besides the point. But what vision it gives, kindly read it. I'll quote a few things from that. First, it said, merely parliamentary arithmetic is not the basis of democracy. Cooperation, conciliation, and consensus is essential for democracy. See, this is what I'm quoting from this address. And then it says, secularism is integral to Indian tradition. This is, I'm quoting the sentence from this address. Not from the manifesto of the Congress Party or Nationalist Congress Party. Secularism is integral to Indian tradition. The government is, it is unequivocal commitment of secular, of the government to uphold secular values. This is what is said in this address. In terms of foreign policy, it talks about the Asian solidarity and regional cooperative and regional cooperation, various groups of regional cooperation. Actually, it has a kind of perspective on foreign policy, a vision on foreign policy. You can agree or disagree. That is besides the point again. So while comparing these two addresses, and especially this one in 1998, with how you can build a new India, it gives that vision. And it is not surprising that there is no mention of communal harmony in the present presidential address. You should not be surprised that there's no mention, because they have not learnt anything from their own NDA government and the government led by Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee. This is what is there. Because of paucity of time, because I have only 15 minutes, so I have to cover other points also. Therefore, I'm not quoting all these things in detail, but there is a perspective about this. The present address does not present a vision of India. The vision of India is based on tolerance, on diversity, on togetherness. And this again, one sentence in this address of the president in 1998 is very important for you to learn, for members of the treasury benches. The governance seeks to unify and not to divide the country. This is very important. And I'm not saying this. This is your presidential address during your own government. This is them. Now, Mr. Shri Amit Shah talked about some new experiments during the BJP government. All other honorable members before me, beginning from the leader of the opposition, Azad Saab, and to Sukhendra Shekhar Rai and Comrade Rangarajan, have talked about all these issues. But I must mention that what kind of image of India we are showing to the world, it depends on the actions of the government. What actions we are doing? New experiments that he talked about, I must mention the new experiments. There are two points that I'll make. One, where BJP, by its political decision, has gone against all values of Indian culture, civilization, and Hindu religion. Why I say this, and I want the Treasury benches to answer this. What is the concept of a yogi? The yogi is who renounces all the material life. No yogi, even the yogis who were born in, those who became sannyasi, and they were born in a royal family like Buddha, renounced that Rajpat. ये पहली बार हुआ है इसका जवाब दीजिएगा महात्मा स्वामी विवेकानंद से लेकर महात्मा गांधी तक किसी ने राजपाट की चिंता नहीं की योगी से लेकर महात्मा तक पहली बार भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने एक काम किया है कि एक मठ के प्रधान को राजपाट दे दिया मुख्यमंत्री बना दिया किसी ने आज तक योगी को मुख्यमंत्री बनाया था किसी ने नहीं ये भारतीय जनता
पार्टी
Yeah.
No. He doesn't speak, sir. Let him allow him, sir.
No.
It's not comment on him. It's on BJP.
It is not on him. No, it is not on him. I did not take the name also. I believe in parliamentary decorum, please. I never interrupt
him. Please don't interrupt.
I never interrupt. Please kindly.
It is his time. Let him finish. Please conclude, Mr. Tripathi.
नाम नहीं लिया ना तो मैंने तो उदाहरण दे दिया जो नया प्रयोग आप कर रहे हैं जरा बताइए किसी ने किसी योगी को कभी राजपाट दिया हो भारत में बताइए हाँ
प्लीज कंक्लूड नाउ प्लीज कंक्लूड
अब दूसरी बात की भी चर्चा कर दूं अभी हमारे एक माननीय सदस्य ने श्री गुलाम नबी आजाद से आपातकाल के बारे में पूछना चाहा इमरजेंसी के बारे में खैर वो कुछ नहीं बोले सदाशयता के कारण मर्यादा के कारण मैं इस पर कुछ कहना चाहता हूं आपके विचार के लिए एक तो देखिए प्रधानमंत्री श्रीमती इंदिरा गांधी ने देश से आपातकाल के बारे में क्षमा मांगी ये कौन बोल रहा है इसको भी ध्यान से सुनिएगा आई डोंट इंडल्ज इन सेल्फ प्रेज बट देयर इज नो बुक ऑन द इमरजेंसी राइट फ्रॉम डेविड सेलबोन टू कूमी कपूर टू लेटेस्ट बाई ए सूर्य प्रकाश विच डज नॉट टॉक अबाउट माई केस एंड माई रोल ड्यूरिंग द इमरजेंसी स्ट्रगल Therefore, I'm saying this, Mrs. Gandhi not merely apologized to the nation, there have been two presidents of the Congress after that who had no role to play whatever, nothing bad during the emergency, and I'm not saying this. Shah Commission said it. Leaders of the Janata Party government in 1977 and 78 said this, that Shri Rajiv Gandhi and Srimati Sonia Gandhi had no role to play whatever during the emergency. This, I'm not saying I've quoted who said it. Now, when BJP talks about that anti-emergency struggle, I never repeat, but today I'm repeating for the consideration of Shri Amit Shah, that by your actions, you have actually humiliated that heroic struggle against the emergency. I consider the best period of my life those 4 months of the underground and 14 months in jail during the emergency. Being that part of the struggle against
emergency. Please conclude now. Please.
Let me.
Yes. You have already exceeded your party time. Please.
No, sir. We are all listening, sir. We are all learning something.
Okay. You have, by your actions, humiliated that anti-emergency struggle. Why? Because two people who were indicted by the Shah Commission appointed by the Janata Party government were made ministers by you. Your party, one of them, who was responsible for atrocities according to Shah Commission, according to all your leaders, is a minister now in the government. So much about anti-emergency struggle. Very briefly, few points about doubling of the income of the farmers. Kindly read the economic survey, okay. Volume 1, page 95. What it says? It says that the income of the farmers in the irrigated sector will decline by 15 to 18%. I'm quoting.
Tripathi ji.
Page 95.
Aapka time over.
Page 95. Oh, just
Tripathi ji, your time is over.
This volume 1, page 95
Tripathi ji,
I will be very brief. I'll take just
three minutes.
Last point I'm making. Just 3 minutes. I want
12 hours
to 14 hours. Leaving foreign policy. There was a lot to be said about foreign policy.
You will. Leaving. Will you give your party's time? Will you give? Who are you? You always intervene like this. No, no. See, Jairam Ramesh should not. Jairam Ramesh should not do this. You always do like this. Will you give your party's time?
5 minutes more.
No, you say.
You have already taken extra 5 minutes.
Sir, mic is with you.
Huh?
Mic on it.
No. See, I have no. One minute. I have no problem in allowing
okay,
10 minutes or 15 minutes. You should decide to sit beyond it. That's all. I have no problem. I have no problem. But no, every party taking more time. Where do what do I do?
Achha, okay. So, I will be very brief. I'll obey your order.
Now decide here and then. Okay. You sit up to 9?
Yes, sir.
Here and now. I have no problem.
Let me.
Okay. Finish in 3 minutes.
Let me just conclude, sir.
Yeah, please.
Allow me 1 minute to conclude.
No. Yes. Allowed.
Allowed. Okay. So, sir, I would not say just one thing. I said 15 to 18% decline in farmers' income in irrigated sector, and 20 to 25% decline in farmers' income in unirrigated sector. This is economic services. Second, about the nature of growth, I will conclude according to you. Nature of growth, you look at, you talk about impressive growth, the address talk. What is that growth? What is the nature of that growth? GDP component is manufacturing, consumption, and export. According to your economic survey, volume 2, page 7, consumption is 95% of your GDP, which means your growth stands on a very feet of clay. And domestic investment has been going down. It was 30% of the GDP in 99, 40% in 2010, 29% now. 26.9. Oi, that is. Now, 26.9. So this is the position of domestic investment. How are you going to strengthen your economy? Ab last mein mein bina jada samay liye hue aapka fir Pradhan Mantri ji ke pirishayak mere mitra Neta Fazli ko hi udhrit kar deta hun. Aapki sarkar jaise kaam karti hai, wo sher usko bakhubi prakat karta hai. Bata deta hai. Sher hai, kabhi kabhi yun hi humne ji ko bahlaya hai. Kabhi kabhi yun hi हमने जी को बहलाया है जिन बातों को खुद न समझे औरों को समझाया
ओके थैंक यू